so because everyone, as you guys know, probably that I had real bad shoulder injuries for a couple of years, and just doctors want to do double surgery on my shoulders. So now after working with Nick, I do a lot of flexibility where I stretch my pec out, stretch my front delt, stretch my lat out before I train. So I thoroughly stretch for 30 minutes. And then I do these flutters. It's face down and hands, so here's parallel, slightly down on about 30 degree angle. I do pinky up for 20, arms flat for 20, and then thumbs up, which is really hard. So a full external rotation up towards the ceiling for 20. So 20, 20, 20, 60 reps, and it pumps that whole upper mid back up, tensions the back up for when ready for when you're pressing. So I do this every single time I press, so it's either shoulders or chest. Like I said, because I've had that bad shoulder injury, I'm really, really careful with my warm-ups and pressing. So I do those exercises I showed you before, and I always start at the 20s. We don't have 20s today, so 22s. I'll do two sets of 15, 20 reps on 20 first, no matter what. And then I jump 10 kilo increments. So say I'm doing 45s today, I'll go 20s, 30s, 40s, or 45s. So I'll do sometimes two or three warm-up sets, or two warm-ups, a couple of prep sets before I do set one, just to be extra safe. A lot of people have asked me how I brought my chest up, and I'll tell you one major thing it was. I stopped barbell pressing. When I was younger, I used to, like we all did, I guess, it was very popular then. The old school way was everyone barbell press. First thing they ask, hey bro, how much do you bench? I used to bench 200 kilos, four reps when I was only 80 kilos. I'm 100 kilos now, 108 off season. That plane there is a bad angle for my shoulder. I found if I lowered my elbows a little bit to this movement plane here, which you can only do with a dumbbell, tuck your elbows in, the chest activation I get there changed my whole development of my chest. It took my front delt and my arms out of the movement and it got better chest activation. So now I'll do mostly dumbbells at the start, incline and a flat, and then I'll stick to machines that mimic the same movement pattern. And then I'll add some flies in and stuff like that. So I don't barbell press at all, not incline, not flat, not decline, zero. And I feel like it's a bit of a dying breed. You look around the gym, no one's using barbell presses anymore. I feel like these days you don't see everyone barbell pressing. But I think people are catching on. It's similar to the squat. I believe, my personal opinion, the risk reward is not there. As I'm warming up and I get towards my target weight, the reps come down. So I did two sets of 20 at the start. I only did 8 reps then of 30. I'm gonna touch 40 now. I'll probably only do 4 to 6 reps of 40 just to feel it out. And the 40 will tell me what my peak weight is gonna be today. So as I'm moving up the rack, bring the reps down. I don't wanna use any of my energy for my big lifts. I used to go balls to the wall, heavy as possible. I don't do that anymore with chest. I'm too afraid of the, when you got injured as bad as I was and they told me potentially my career was over, I don't do no crazy, like if I can do 60s, doesn't mean I can do the 60s. Often I'll opt to do the 50s instead and keep more tension on the muscle and be smoother. And it's less risk on my shoulder joint. The heavier I go, the more I feel it on the joint. And I just want to feel it on the muscle. I don't give a fuck about what weight it is. Keep it pretty slow. I'd rather do that than go a bit heavy and be sloppy. I'd actually move to that machine over there. It's a better flat press. I don't don't go that heavy on this, to be honest. Bro, I'm so much rounder this time, it's like... everything is just bigger. It's gonna be good. Bro, this week I've been getting leaner and my weight's been going up. So my weight's been coming down 199, 98, all the way to 95, till last week. Then this week, 96, 97, back up, and I'm fucking leaner every day. Another thing I do, same thing, everyone should do this anyway, whether you've got a bad shoulder or not, is chop these up. So put a plate under there, because when you're thick, especially like me, it's too low. You don't want, who wants to start a press here? It's too dangerous. That's how I did my AC joint initially. Someone should have lifted it up the first 2 inches. I was in a machine in Doherty's in Melbourne, I was stuck like this, and had four plates aside, and I was just going like this, and I was something popped in my shoulder. So the best way to avoid that, lift the starting point up a little bit. And once again, you know how I said you want your elbows tucked in? This machine mimics that, this angle here. So that's a good angle for the press. I like to opt to this machine as over dumbbells. Well, especially when I've already done one exercise with dumbbells anyway. We've got an amazing press here, bro. That fly machine is the best. That opens your chest up. That's amazing, we'll do that next. Such a good fly press, bro. Not many lift gyms have that where the bench goes over that like that, you know? See, I really emphasize the negative on that. You can see the negative 3 times lower than the positive. It's just, that's what I found works the best for me, you know? I've never seen myself look this crazy, bro.
Yeah.
I'm so excited. I'm literally doing the hardest show in the world. It's the hardest show outside the Olympics in New York, and I look the best I've ever looked. If I can win this show, I'll make history forever. Highest place ever Australian in a New York pro is 6th place. I'm obliterating that record, bro. We'll have to wait and see. And it's going to be the strongest New York pro, they reckon, ever. So there's no excuses that anyone can say, oh, you had a weak lineup. No. It's going to be, they reckon it's the biggest. Patrick told me he reckons could be 30 dudes. That's bigger than Olympia. Like in regards of numbers, I can't get ahead of it myself. I just got to keep ticking the boxes. I'm confident in my own ability, but bro, these are the best guys in the world. I'm not silly. You remember, a lot of these guys are weighing at 96, 212 on the dot, and I'll probably be 92. So they're big boys, man. I'm not under any delusion, but I'm very balanced. I know that for a fact. If I can just be the leanest, that's it. If I'm the leanest and the most balanced, I should be right. I can't have a bad result if I tick those 2 boxes. I can't control the rest of it, so who cares, you know? One show I'm very, very, very confident, is Toronto. Let's just focus on New York first. Oh, that machine is the best, man. This is another reason why I came back to this gym. That machine is so good. It just feels amazing. By leaning back like that, curving your spine, you're opening your chest right up. It's the best feeling I've felt of any fly machine I've ever used. You say people, sometimes when you tell people about shit, you fucking derail it. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you're best off keeping shit to yourself.
Yeah.
Until it's 100% done. The amount of times I've said, I'm getting this, I'm getting that.
Yeah.
Or fucking, I'm counting my money before I got it right. Something fucking happens and I don't get it right. You know how many times that's happened to me in my life? All the time, man. Like selling a truck one time, I'm like, I'm gonna get 120 grand. I was supposed to get 90, and I was getting 120. I'm like, yes, I'm gonna fucking make bank. And I told a few mates, I'm gonna make fucking bank off this truck. Can't went missing, bro. He flew to the Gold Coast, supposed to give me cash deposit. He was up here with his mates and he went missing. You fucking derail it. Conor McGregor talks about it. You best not just shut the fuck up. Back in the day, I should strip down here and pose in here. Not allowed to do it now, but I used to wear posing trunks under my shorts, and I just strip down right here. And everyone used to sit there and watch, and now everyone gets too offended. I'm not gonna do it. If everyone else is not allowed to do it, then I'm not gonna do it.
Yeah,
sure. That's, you know, it's not fair. Like I told you though, when I get shredded old, I'll wear a shoestring singlet,
yeah,
and footy shorts. I was thinking right at the last video before we go, I'll wear a stringer and some Broncos footy shorts. And I'll be like, next to nothing. I'm gonna take my shirt off. Why cover up? Because I think you get to the point where you get muscle dysmorphia. You know, you feel small all the time and you're actually huge. How many big pros you see overseas, and especially Americans, they'll have a fucking 5XL t-shirt on and fucking trucky ducks, bro. Because I think they just don't want anyone to look at them.
It's because you have good and bad days, then you don't want
to. Yeah, so you block it out every day. Yeah, you never worry. I feel you on that one.
Always have the neutral days.
You're fully covered, you never really see. And maybe once a week, go in the posing room alone and see how you look once a week.
Yeah.
And there's no pressure. That just goes to show you how much pressure they fucking put on themselves. I raced motocross for 6 years, and that made my forearms pretty thick, but I think it's just genetics, bro. I should train them and see what happens. It's like calves, man. I had big, medium-sized calves, never trained them ever. And like, I've been training them lately, and they've been fucking blowing up. But I got more gifted forearms than calves. I should just train them once a week, or even start one movement a week for a month, and then maybe go to 2 minutes to see what happens. Make them fucking leap priest level. Finish on this movement that my mate Sam showed me. You lay flat on the bench and you go push up, push down, you drag the bar across your face, just miss your face, and hang the bar down and stretch the tricep, back, just miss your nose again, and then push it up. It doesn't sound like much, but it's fucking hard. Funny how Alex said that my shoulders are like overpowering. Bro, 4 months ago, Patrick said my shoulders are too small. So I started training them again. I wasn't training any delts at all. And now, my shoulders aren't small now. It's because my arms are big. The shoulders have to be, if they're not massive, mate, my arms overpower the delt. Like the arms will look bigger than the delt, and it shouldn't be like that. Yeah. To be honest, I still reckon the shoulders could be a little bit more bigger. The arms are still bigger. And then if I crunch down more, see that? The shoulder disappears a little bit more. I think I could still do a little bit more delt size. Chest today, guys. A lot of you wanted to know how I brought my chest up, so you got a little insight today in what I do and how I set my chest training up. As you can see, it's improved a lot the last 2 years, so thanks for tuning in.